What's up guys, Sal here. So the official launch event for the Pixel 6 and 6 Pro is scheduled to take place on October 19th, but details regarding the handsets keep on surfacing, revealing every last bit of info. Today, in what's arguably the biggest leak we've seen so far regarding the Pixel 6 handsets, a new hands-on video as well as the camera samples and video samples of the Pixel 6 Pro has been revealed. This information is coming from This Is Tech Today. He has a source in Nigeria who already got the Pixel 6 Pro from somewhere. With that said, here is the new hands-on video of the Pixel 6 Pro. In the last leaked video of the handset, we saw that the curved display was looking more prominent, just like the old Samsung phones. And that, even though looks great, but not at all offer a good user experience, mainly due to the accidental touch activations. But turns out the phone doesn't have aggressive display curves as the old video suggested. The new video with a white background shows the phone has a similar display curve as the Galaxy S21 Ultra. And for those who've never used the phone, the S21 Ultra has the perfect curved display because it rarely gets any accidental touches. Moving on, here's a close-up of the front-facing earpiece speaker on the 6 Pro. The Pixel 5 had an under-display speaker, which quite frankly was not even good, so glad that Google has decided to go with the conventional speaker system with the new handsets. Now, moving to the camera, as you can see, the user interface for photos show 4 different zoom range, 0.7x, 1x, 2x, and 4x, while the video has 3, 0.7x, 1x, and 4x. The UI shows that all the camera features of the past Pixel phones have been retained. Now, here is the video sample from the Pixel 6 Pro. Keep in mind that this person isn't a photographer or a tech YouTuber. It's just an average consumer, plus this is a pre-release phone with unfinished software. It's not an ideal phone to form an opinion on, so keep that in mind while judging the photos and videos. With that said, the video is filmed at 1080p, which makes it a bit harder to judge the true quality. But it looks good. One thing I would like to mention is the optical image stabilization seems to be not on par with other flagships like the Galaxy S21 Ultra. I mean, you can feel every step is taken. For comparison, here's the iPhone 13 Pro Max versus the S21 Ultra's stabilization test. It's safe to say the Pixel 6 Pro is around the same ballpark as the iPhone 13 Pro Max when it comes to video stabilization, with the S21 Ultra clearly better than these two. Anyway, here are some camera samples from the handset. In this portrait photo, the bokeh effect looks solid and details are pretty great as well, courtesy of the 50 megapixel camera. Google is using pixel binning 4x1 for 12.5 megapixel images, but still these are pretty sharp images even when you crop in multiple times. The best example is this image of a green home where details of both the road and the house's balcony are clearly visible. All in all, with all the camera samples we have so far from the hands of an average consumer, what do you think about the Pixel 6 Pro's camera? Let me know down in the comments. And as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.